Hi, assalamu alaikum. So we are going to start our new semester with the first chapter, electrostatic. So in electrostatic, we have four subtopics. The first subtopic is Coulomb's law. Under Coulomb's law, we have three learning outcomes. We are going to look at it one by one. But before that, let's talk briefly about electrostatic. Electrostatic refers to static electricity or stationary electric charge. So electro here, electricity. Static here is static or stationary. So meaning that we are going to learn about static electric charge. Okay, electric charge that is not moving. Okay, we know that charges, we have positive charge and negative charge. If we have, if we place two charges, positive and negative, they will attract each other. If we place negative and negative next to each other, they will repel each other. And same as positive and positive, they will repel each other. So we're going to learn about all of these charges based on the force acting on it, the electric field acting on it, and electric potential. So kita akan tengok in terms of tiga benda lah, force, field, and potential. Okay, so in this first subtopic, we are going to focus on the electric force ataupun electrostatic force. It is the same thing. Okay, so this electrostatic force we can explain based on Coulomb's law. Okay, Coulomb's law states that the magnitude of the electrostatic force between the two point charges is proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So this whole statement, basically dia cakap kita boleh translate kepada this formula here. Di mana force is equal to K. K adalah electrostatic constant, this value. And then we have Q and Q, the product of the two charges. And we only take the magnitude of the charge and divide it by R square. R here is the distance between the charges. Or we can also use this formula. Basically, it's the same thing. Di mana kita gunakan in terms of permittivity of free space, this E naught. So this is also a constant value at 0.85 exponent negative 12. So benda yang sama Q times Q, magnitude of the charge, divided by 4 pi E naught R square. Okay, so let's consider here two positive charges. So we have Q1 and Q2. Okay, so when we place these two charges next to each other, we know since they are both positive, we know that they will force acting on it, but they will be opposite direction. So kind of the force opposite direction, since they are positive then positive, they will repel each other. So this force will be the same. Okay, it will be the same in magnitude, but different, but opposite in direction. So let's say lah dekat sini, the force acting on this is equal to 100 Newton. Okay, and then we double the charge here. So contoh lah kita double the charge here. This one masih sama, Q1. This one 2, Q2. We double the charge. And the distance between these two charges is still the same. Okay, so according to the Coulomb's law, okay, this Coulomb's law, when the charge increase, the force will increase. Okay, sebab dia adalah directly proportional. So, kalau kita doublekan the charge, force juga akan double. So, meaning that here, the force will be equal to 200 Newton. Okay, because it is directly proportional to the charge. Okay, if if we double the distance. So now, kita double the distance to R from the initial value. So initially, it is just value, maybe 1 centimeter lah. Okay, and then kita double kan jadi 2 centimeter. So according to this formula, F is inversely proportional to the distance. Meaning that when R increase, F will decrease. So R increase, F will decrease. Okay, but since we double the distance, okay, F dia tidak akan kurang by half. Kenapa? Sebab kita ada square. So kalau kita ada square, okay, let's say here, kita letak, okay, let's say lah, kita letak tadi 1 centimeter kan, initially this one is 1 centimeter, okay, 1 meter lah. Okay, we use SI unit, 1 meter, so here will be 2 meter. So here, it will be 2 meter. Dan kita akan square kan. So maksudnya kita akan dapat 4, 1 over 4. So the force will decrease by 1 over 4. So the force here will be equal to 1 over 4 of the initial force. Sorry, I didn't put this one here. Initial force, this one. 100. So it will be 25 Newton. Okay, kamu boleh nampak kan tu the relationship between this this parameter here. So kita ada apabila Q increase. So apabila Q increase, Q increase, F akan increase. R increase, F akan decrease. Dan this one kamu kena hati-hati sebabkan the initial formula, the original formula is R square. So F dia akan decrease by 1 over 4. Depends lah on the formula here, on the value here. Okay, next one is the second second learning outcome, which is to sketch the electric force diagram. So sketching here is very important because it is used to indicate the direction of the force. Okay, but it is very easy. Kita hanya tengok dua situation saja apabila kita ada charge yang sama, positive-positive ataupun positive, positive-positive ataupun negative-negative. So, charge yang sama kita tahu dia akan repel each other. So, it will repel each other. Maksudnya, direction dia akan opposite direction. Here. And charge yang berbeza, positive dan negative, they will attract each other. So, direction will be towards each other. And remember, the force here is the same value. Force dekat sini adalah sama value dengan dekat sini. Tetapi, direction akan berbeza. Okay, so here, kita akan gunakan numbering to label the force. So, the force here is the force on 2. So, force yang dikenakan ke atas Q2 daripada Q1. So, Q1 yang kenakan force ke atas Q2. So, kita akan letak 1, 2. And then here will be 2, 1. Force yang dikenakan oleh 2 ke atas 1. Like that. So, that's how you label the force. So, sama juga dengan dekat sini. This one will be force by 1 on 2 by 2 on 1. Okay, so this label is very important sebab kadang-kadang soalan akan terus cakap what is F12. Walaupun the magnitude will be the same but direction akan berbeza. So, kamu kena hati-hati dekat sini. Okay, so this is how you sketch the electric force diagram. Okay, that's all for this video. We are going to see the example in the next video.